गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सनी कुमार गुप्ता फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट गाइड एंड यूट्यूब चैनल। एंड टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट एंड दैट टाइम सिक्स एंड सेवन्थ क्लास मैथ्स गोइंग ऑन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर क्लास फॉर टुडे, फ्रैक्शन। एंड टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट कंपेयरिंग ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। सो हाउ टू कंपेयर द फ्रैक्शन, इट मीन्स हु इज ग्रेटर दैन एंड हु इज a smaller than. So firstly, that's the first rule is comparing the fraction. Firstly, you see denominator. When given two fractions with the same denominator, if there are two fractions are available, so firstly you see if two denominator is same, then the one of the one with the greater numerator is the greater of two. यानी कि जो आपका two fractions है उस fractions का जो denominator होगा यदि वो equal है, यदि वो equal हो तो ऊपर यानी numerator का जो part होगा जो greater रहेगा वो आपको greater than होता है। It means clear? It means denominator, the one with the greater number is the greater of two, greater number. So 7 and 6, who is greater number? It means 7 is the greater number. So you put that thing of, it means 7 by 9 is 6 by 9. It means who? 7 by 9 is greater than 6 by 9. Is that clear? Next example, just like here. 9 by 4, 8 by 4. So first rule says if denominator is same. So if denominator is same, then you see numerator. If which numerator is large, greater, that fraction is greater. Okay. It means 9 and 8. So 9 is greater than 8. So you put that same. It means 9 by 4 is greater than 8 by 4. That's another rule. How to find if different fractions given, how to suggest which is greater than and which is smaller than. That's a cross multiplication rule. Just like here, by cross multiplication method. It means firstly you multiply the cross. It means A by B and B by C. So A by D and B by C. You multiply, then which number is greater, after that you suggest that number is greater than is that number. Okay, it means 7 by 9 and 6 by 9. 7 by 9 and 6 by 9. So you multiply that number and you multiply with that number. First 7 multiply 9 and 9 multiply 6. 63 and 9 6 are 54. Who is greater? It means 63 is greater than 7, 9 are 63. 7, 9 are. It means who is greater than 7 by 9 and 6 by 9. So that number is greater than. Okay. It means 7 by 9 is greater than 6 by 9. That's a very simple way. Firstly, you multiply with cross, by cross multiplication method. Then you suggest who is greater than and who is smaller than. Is that clear? So that's a very simple rule for you. How to convert the, who is greater and who is smaller than. So is that clear? Next topic, when given two fractions with the same numerator, if numerator is same, then the one with the smaller denominator is the greater of the two. आसान से भाषा में बोले तो आपका जब भी किसी भी फ्रैक्शन का जब डिनोमिनेटर इक्वल होता है तो न्यूमिरेटर का जो छोटा पार्ट होता है, छोटा नंबर होता है, वो आपको बड़ा हो जाएगा, जो बड़ा रहता है वो छोटा हो जाता है। सो इज दैट क्लियर? इट मीन्स इफ न्यूमिरेटर इज सेम दैट्स विच नंबर डिनोमिनेटर इज ए स्मॉल, which denominator is small, it means if numerator is same and denominator is different, so which denominator is small, which denominator denominator is small, that's fraction is greater than. That's fraction is greater than. So you see here 5 by 6 and 5 by 8. So what says that's the numerator is same. It means 5 by 6 and 5 by 8. Both are equal. Numerator is equal. So you see which denominator is as small. Which denominator is as small? It means 5 by 6 denominator is as small. So that number is greater than. That number is greater than. Why? Because your rule says when given two fraction with the same numerator, the one of the a smaller denominator, it means which is a smaller, 6 is a smaller, then the greater the 2. It means both number, both fractions, that 5 by 6 and 5 by 8 is 5 by 6 is greater than 5 by 8. Is that clear? Next example for you. Numerator is same. It means 8 by 7 and 8 by 11. So both numerator is same. So second step is you see denominator. Which denominator is a smaller and which denominator is greater. So that's a 7 is a smaller. That 7 is a smaller. So you put the thing by that greater than. It means 8 by 7 is greater than 8 by 11. Why? Because your rule says numerator is same and denominator is different. So which denominator is a smaller, that fraction is greater than. Is that clear? And that's rule which if denominator is same, if denominator is same and which numerator is greater than, that fraction is greater than. Is that clear? And here also. So firstly you note down your copy, then we have start our next topic. Okay, so next topic, next question, just like next question come in your book, come in your exam, that's arrange the fraction in that 2 by 3, 1 by 6, 4 by 6, 3 by 9 in ascending and descending order. So how to arrange the ascending and descending order? So firstly, you also know how to find the who is greater and who is a smaller fraction. So if you find out that who is greater and who is a smaller, after that you also find the ascending order and descending order. So my dear students, that's the same rule, just like here. Firstly you take the LCM of all number. And you change the fraction with denominator. It means if your LCM is 36, LCM is 36, so you change in fraction with 36 of denominator, and you get, after that you arrange in ascending order and descending order also. So firstly you take the what? LCM. LCM of 3, 6, 6, 9. Okay. So firstly 2, 3, 3, 3 and 9. Also again 3, 1, 1, 1 and 3. Is that clear? It means 2 multiply 3 multiply 3. 2, 3 is 6 and 6, 3 is 18. 3, 3 is 9, 9, 2 is 18. The LCM of 18. Total LCM of 18. It means right here, LCM of 3, 6, 6 and 9 is equal to 18. Is that clear? LCM is 3, 6, 6, 9 is equal to 18. Okay, so next you convert all fraction with denominator is 19. You convert all fraction with denominator 18. Is that clear? So now right here, now convert all fraction. Convert all fractions. It means you convert all fractions. So firstly you take 2 by 3. Is that clear? 2 by 3. So
If you read, firstly, what you want? It means 18. That's your denominator is 18. Your denominator is 18. So, which table you read in, which times you read of table of 3, then you get 18. 6, 3, 3, 6, 18. And that same number you also multiply with numerator. It means which number you take of multiple of denominator, at that same number you also multiply with numerator. 6 2s are 12 and 3 6 are 18. That's your number. Next, 1 by 6. It means 1 by 6. So what is your denominator? 18. So 6 3s are 18. Multiply with 3. After that you get 3 by 18. Is that clear? Next, 4 by 6. 4 by 6. When you multiply with 6, it means 3. Okay? 12 by 18. Is that clear? Next, 3 by 9. Here, 3 multiple 9. It means 9 twos are 18. 3 twos are 6 and 9 twos are 18. So that's your fraction. That's your fraction of 2 by 3 is equal to 12 by 18. 1 by 6 is equal to 3 by 18. 4 by 6 is equal to 12 by 18. And 3 by 9 is equal to 6 by 18. So, is that clear? So, that's your number. It means, firstly, you arrange that number. And you also know if when our denominator is same. When our denominator is same, who is greater and who is smaller? If when denominator is same, then which number is greater than, that's your greater number, then not same, that's your another type. Is that clear? It means, firstly you write here, who is smaller than denominator. When denominator is same, that's a smaller number is greater number, and then numerator is same, then greater number of denominator is greater. Is that clear? It means, firstly you arrange with ascending order. In ascending order. Ascending order. Okay. So that's number 12 by 18. 3 by 18, 12 by 18, and here 6 by 18. 6 by 18, 12 by 18, 3 by 18, and 12 by 18 also. Okay, so that form, is that clear? It means when you start arrange in ascending order, how to arrange. So who is smaller than? It means 3. 3 by 18 is smaller. So firstly you write 3 by 18. Is that clear? Listen, my dear students, here both are equal. Both number are equal. So, you change that number. It means here 5. Here 5 by 6 also. Okay. 4 by 6 means 5 by 6. Okay. 5 by 6. Here 5. It means 5 3 is a 15. 15 by 18. Is that clear? So, when you arrange 3 by 18, ascending order. Ascending order means a smaller to greater, a smallest to greatest number, just like go up stairs. Is that clear? It means 3 by 18 and second number just greater 3, and next number is 6 by 18. Is that clear? Next number 6 by 18 means 12 by 18. 12 by 18 and last number is 15 by 18. So, you arrange in that way, but firstly you arrange that number. Who is 3 by 18? It means 1 by 6. Next number, 6 by 18. 6 by 18 means 3 by 9. 3 by 9. Next number, 12 by 18. 12 by 18. It means 2 by 3. And next number, here, 15 by 18 means 5 by 6. That's the ascending order. Next question, same question, you convert in descending order. Just like here, ascending means as smallest to greatest. Just opposite, it means you arrange descending order greatest to as smallest. It means come with stairs and go up stairs. Go up ascending order and come down descending order. So when you convert in descending order, descending order, that's number is equal, but first who is greater than, who is greater, 15 by 18 means 5 by 6, so you write here 5 by 6, and who is the smaller, just 5 by 6, it means 2 by 3, next number 3 by 9, and next number 1 by 6. That's your ascending order and that's your descending order. My dear students, in your exam, in your exercise, says arrange in ascending order and arrange in descending order. That's different question in your exam, different question in your exercise book. And another question, just like fill in the blanks, convert, suggest, yeah, find out who is greater than and who is smaller than. So how do you crack, my dear student? Firstly, you take, if numerator here, if numerator and denominator, numerator, that's a two topic, numerator is as same and denominator is same, so how to convert, and if you don't know when, how to justify the who is greater than and who is smaller than, firstly you take by cross multiplication method, then you find out who is greater and who is smaller. But my dear student, that rule is very necessary for only two fractions. If more than two fractions are given, then firstly you take LCM of all numbers, LCM of all number, and change the all fraction with LCM. It means which is LCM is come, that's with denominator. Just like here, firstly you find out the LCM of, LCM is called to 18. Then after that you convert in all fractions, all fractions with denominator 18. Is that clear? So your topic is finished today. So firstly you write down in your copy, then we have discuss about next class. My dear student, today's our topic is finished, and next, yesterday, tomorrow we have also discussed our next topic. So let us stay home and save your life and continue your study. Thank you.